Hey, what's up guys? My name is Thomas Bark. Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about what are some of the best private and kind of secure alternatives to Discord. Now, Discord is one of the best, you know, chat applications out there for gamers, but it's not necessarily good for the privacy community. Why is that? Well, it's because Discord pretty much collects everything you do on the platform. It can collect all the data, all the messages, your IPs and stuff like that, give them out to law enforcement agencies if you do something wrong. And they can also sell it to third parties and stuff like that. Now, of course, Discord has kind of said in the past that they don't plan to sell any of this data. But, you know, seeing Discord's little store that sold games fail, they're clearly looking for a way to make money with the platform, even though a lot of people use it. Discord Nitro, I think, has made them a little bit money, but honestly, not that many people use it since it's a little too expensive. So, you know, what other way do they have to make money besides, you know, selling data since it is a free program? So you might be thinking, you know, what other programs should I use? Well, there are a lot of chat programs out there, and I made a video about the best encrypted messengers, talking about Signal, Wire, WickerMe, as well as stuff like Telegram and WhatsApp that do have encryption capabilities, but a lot of these applications aren't really, you know, the same thing as Discord. So I've spent some time researching and finding some of the most Discord-like alternatives out there to Discord that I could find. This means that they're kind of more like group-based messaging platforms with rooms, moderation privileges, and stuff like that that is similar to Discord. Now, keep in mind, you know, most of the stuff on this list I don't think is quite up there in terms of Discord, in terms of the usability, as well as, you know, all these bots and different customization with notifications and subgroups and, you know, various rooms and stuff like that, as well as gaming integrations. But I do think these two alternatives both do have their own kind of cool things about them, and they are perfectly usable, as well as much more privacy friendly in terms of encryption and just kind of respecting your user data. Alright guys, so without further ado, let's... Hey guys, just a reminder to check out vpntierlist.com. It's a collection of all my ratings on the channel, and you're going to find lots of helpful information here on how to choose a VPN. Anyways, back to the video. First one on this list is going to be keybase.io, and I'm going to be kind of running you through what it looks like to use this application, what it's like to use it, what are some of the pros and cons about it. So one of my favorite things about this application is that it's extremely user-friendly, has very good setup guides and tutorials, and you can use it very easily, pretty much similar to Discord in that aspect. Pretty much anyone can use it. So basically what you're going to do starting out, you install it and you're going to pick a username. Then you're going to pick your computer device. And then once you do this, you're going to, you can either put a phone number so people could find you, or you could just skip it. You can also allow friends to find you by this email address, and I'm going to skip that for now. So this is what the basic kind of interface looks like. So you have your chats here. You could join a team, or you can make a team. You can also talk to specific people. You could find them by email address, phone number, or if they provide you their username. The cool thing about this is that you can also add files to your kind of Keybase account, and these are encrypted. So that is an interesting kind of thing that you could do that you can't do with Discord. You also have wallets, which is really cool. So if you like Stellar, it's one of the newer cryptocurrencies. So it's pretty cool. It had a really good rise in the bull run with, you know, the altcoins and stuff like that. You know, it's not been getting as much attention now, but it is a cool cryptocurrency. So the cool thing about this is that you can use a Stellar wallet on here. If you do like Stellar, got a little bot notification down here. So it is encrypted. That's cool. Here's some Git repositories. You can make repositories or a team repository for coding, as well as devices. And you can create a paper key in case you lose access to your devices. So that's really cool. I would say that's definitely more secure than Discord. Not only that, but we have a lot of settings here. You can customize things here, look at integrations with files, change the dark and light. I actually quite like this dark mode, as well as that. So yeah, you do have a good amount of options here. So this is going to be a really cool kind of alternative to Discord. As you could see, you could privately message people like this, and has quite a good interface, has different support for emojis, GIFs, and you can even send people Stellar Lumens, which I was talking about, the cryptocurrency. And you know, it's just a good messenger. Probably my favorite thing about it though is that it's kind of similar to Discord in that you can create teams. So if I make a team called Tom Spark Reviews YouTube, or Tom Spark Review. I don't think I can make it longer than that. I can't make it like that without spaces. So let's do Tom Spark Review YouTube. Create that. And then I could, you know, make an avatar. I could do that later. So I am now the owner of this little chat group. And I could chat here with anyone. And now I could send people this invitation if I want to. I can add people like this, search keybase. Now I can also customize the settings of this group, just kind of like in Discord. I have my team right here. Now I can also add channels. This is the general channel. I could do a new chat channel. So you can also publish the team on your own profile so people could easily join your kind of team or your channel. You can also publicize the team on Keybase. So this is an easy way to send people invitations. So you could publicize it and then send people the invite that way. You can also customize if it's an open team or don't allow a request to join this team. You can also include auto deletion, which is pretty cool. So that's like a little bit more secure. So for example, you can also create sub teams. So this is going to be more useful for moderators and stuff like that. So I could create a sub team called moderators. So now there will be like the regular team, and then there will be the moderator team. So as you can see here, I have moderators and then the regular team. So you can kind of create sub teams. So that's pretty cool. It takes a little bit of a learning curve to learn how all these kind of teams work. But it is cool. So you could see this is kind of like the main team, the big team, and then we have this sub team here. So that's cool. That's kind of why it reminds me of Discord a little bit, because you could create these different sub teams and stuff like that. And it's cool because your team could kind of like access files together and stuff like that, which is pretty cool. So it's a good way to kind of share files and stuff like that. It's kind of got like that business aspect of collaboration, but I think it also is very user friendly enough and cool enough to use just with people. You know, your friends and stuff like that. So sometimes it's like not as user-friendly as Discord. So like with Discord, you could kind of just right click things and stuff like that, delete the channel. But here it's like you're gonna have to click on this little cogwheel, manage chat channel, and then of course, you know, we can edit the channel at this point and delete that channel. So there you go. It does require, like I said, a little bit of a learning curve. Now another option is riot.im. It's made by kind of the technology behind Matrix, which is kind of like decentralized encrypted chat and collaboration. So riot.im is kind of like a subset. It's like an app created on like that kind of technology slash network. So the cool thing about riot.im is that it's like a little bit like more decentralized than Keybase, and it does have some cool features as well. However, my main complaint with Riot is that there are a couple things that you have to consider. So if you're using like a free server hosted by matrix.org, not something like premium, you are going to notice that the speeds on it are going to be kind of slow. So let's say you type in a message and it's going to like send it, but there is going to be kind of like a delay. So that's a little bit annoying. I've also found that getting people to join the matrix.org or your chat room on riot.im, it can be a little bit clunky. It can be a bit confusing for people who aren't as, you know, in depth with this kind of encrypted technologies and chats and things like this, decentralized chats. So it's a little bit more of a learning curve, I would say, than keybase.io. It's kind of similar to Discord in the overall functionality and interface. But again, it's a little bit tricky to onboard people into the actual channels and stuff like that. But this is, you know, how you're going to do it. So basically, you can create a chat or account right here. I'm going to just make a sample one. Let's do Tarm Sparky. I'm going to make it right here. We're not going to use an email for right now. So we're going to register that. I don't really care about that for now. I'm going to say I'm not a robot. I'm going to accept the terms and conditions. Accept. So now it's starting up. So this is kind of what the interface looks like. And like I said, it looks similar to Discord in a way. But, you know, the functionalities are kind of weird. So RiotBot is chatting to me. This is how you type to people. And, you know, so what we can do is look at some of the settings. So we do have some settings here, and this is kind of like my kind of username, I guess. Of course, you can upgrade to your own domain as well if you want to. Here's some of the settings. You could match the system theme. So I do like how it has kind of like that system theme match setting. That's cool. We'd have some other options like flares and things like that. Some preferences here. A lot of preferences here. So it's a little bit maybe more customizable in some ways than Keybase. So you can see we do have voice and video options as well. So I think that could be considered, you know, one significant advantage over keybase.io is I don't think it has like voice or video support in the same way that this one does. So that's cool. So let's go ahead and like look what it looks like to create a community. We can make this just kind of a sample one. Sample, create it. So this is the new community. So you can get your own server, of course, but you can also have your own community. So I'm trying to get in there right now. So now that we created the server, we can kind of create these rooms. And what you'll do is you'll see that I'm in this one right here. Now you can create the rooms like this. So we could do like, let's do gaming. So we can create that room and it'll create the room within this server. So these are kind of like, the rooms are kind of like the subset of the overall kind of channel. It's a little bit confusing though, like I said, because it's like you're creating these rooms, but you also have the channel here, and then it's showing like your profile here, but it's not like showing the channel here necessarily. And it can be kind of confusing figuring out, like, you know, making a room within the subset of the channel. It's not exactly like as easy as Discord. You could also customize the notifications in here a little bit like Discord as well. So mentions only, you can mute it, each one individually, which is cool. I'm going in, so as you can see there. You can also favorite different servers. You can leave specific channels or rooms within the server. You can even give it like local addresses. Publish the rooms to direct matrix directories to get more people to join them perhaps. You could even get like some community flares and stuff like that. So that's kind of like the basic gist of riot.im. I think Keybase is, you know, easy to use, and this one can be easy to use as well. So probably the easiest way to join a room then would be go to explore, I think, and then you're going to want to look it up by the name of it is. So we look up Thomas Park Reviews. We can find this server or this room, and you can easily join it. However, I'm not really on that room. I don't really moderate it. I don't really use it. So that's just how it is. Mostly because I don't have time to talk to trolls all day. Anyways, guys, so those are my thoughts on Keybase and riot.im. Well, both of them are actually very similar, both provide encryption options to communicate with people. In some ways, Keybase.io kind of has more functionality for like teams in some ways. It kind of feels like more team-oriented, more business. But I think it's also has a little bit better of an interface. It's a little bit more usable than riot.im in some ways. Keybase also has some interesting features with files and some cryptocurrency integration with Stellar. Whereas riot.im feels a little bit more similar to Discord in some ways. Having like the ability to search out rooms and join them is pretty cool. Not only that, but you can like create custom communities and then rooms within those communities that are linked, and you can also link other rooms to other communities. So there's a lot of control there, but it also makes it a little bit confusing. So guys, let me know what you thought of these two options to Discord, if you like them better than Discord, if you'd ever use them over Discord. I think Discord definitely is a little bit easier to pick up and start using quicker than these apps, but these apps also have some interesting privacy advantages as well as some similar capabilities if you take the time to kind of figure out how to use it and make the rooms and stuff like that. Anyways, guys, those are my thoughts on these two alternatives to Discord, and I'll see you again on the next video very soon.